there's some spin. And that's the one we were talking about when he gets that slight round arm delivery. Be a little disquieting for the dressing room.
A lot of turn and bunks there. Shovin Campbell must have been a little bit surprised.
No more runs added. Stuart Williams remained 16 not out, even though he looked as though he was ill out on the field there. And Sherwin Campbell, 8, 1 extra, no wicket for 25. A good start for the West Indies. They got through without losing wicket. And the bowlers used for England, just 3 of them. Fraser, 6 overs, 4 maidens, no wicket for 9. Cork, 8 overs for 16. And Watkinson, 5 overs, 5 maidens, naught for naught. And I can tell you that ball is turning out there. It will be of great interest to Michael Atherton, and it'll have caught the eyes of the West Indian batsmen as well. So at the close of play on the second day of this Cornhill Test, the West Indies 415 runs behind. And
in this Test cricket, introduced by Richie Benno.
When Graham Hick batted in the second innings at Edgbaston, he was part of an England collapse and defeat in 2 1/3 days. When he batted at Trent Bridge yesterday, he made 118 out of 219, and England with 440 in their first innings had a glimpse of victory. Yesterday evening, Mike Watkinson, the off-spinner, turned the ball sharply in his 5 overs, all of them maidens. But this, believe me, is a very, very good batting track. There are plenty of runs there for the West Indies. Welcome to the highlights of the third day's play in this Cornhill Test match at Trent Bridge. We've had two great days so far, looking forward to another one now. This is the way it began at the start of the third day. 25 for no wicket at the West Indies, with Williams 16 and Campbell 8. There's one extra there and 25 on the board. So they were quite happy when they went back to the dressing room yesterday evening. And the bowling figures for England, 3 bowlers used, Fraser, Cork and Watkinson. And the state of the game, the West Indies 415 runs behind. They need in all 241 to save the follow-on. Here now with his pitch report is Geoffrey Boycott.
Third morning on this very dry pitch. Well, nothing's changed on a length here for the seam bowlers. It's still flat. The cracks haven't opened at all, so the seamers are going to have to work very hard. The cracks are very fine, look. Nothing much there for the seamers to work on. They're just going to have to pressurise the batsmen, and that's why I think the England spinners are going to have to do a bit of work. We look here on a length for the England finger spinners. A lot of stud marks here. One or two bowlers bowling around the wicket. You can see here the little marks that have been made. And I think the finger spinners who bowl it a bit quicker than the West Indian leg spinner, they might get a bit of turn and cause a few tricks and problems for the West Indies batsmen. Look here. Just there, there's your soil. One or two little holes coming. This one's a bit too full. And I think also they'll use these footholes at this side. Remember, 3 of the top 6 West Indian batsmen are left-handers, and they'll be able to use these, well, Watkinson and Richard Illingworth, to cause a few problems for the left-handers. So all in all, still a flat good pitch for batting, but I think England's finger spinners, they've got to do the tricks for England.
Indeed they have, and the critical thing on a pitch like this where there is some spin and plenty of bounce is that the two spinners, Watkinson and Illingworth, must keep the ball up to the bat. They must be dragging the West Indians forward all the time. Bowl short and they'll be caned. We join play now with the third ball of the second over. Watkinson already has bowled a maiden, his 6th on the trot, and Williams has taken a boundary from Richard Illingworth. Here he is now and facing the same bowler. Well, he's got away with it. The shout there was catch it, and it didn't go very far away from the man at mid-off.
Well, a very risky shot this. He hit it well enough, but didn't go that high. It went very catchable height, just above head high. Well, Jack Russell just got a knock from a poor ball to pick up, but lovely spin by Richard Illingworth.
Well, I think Michael Atherton will have to start thinking about a short extra cover and a short mid-on. Push his mid-on, mid-off back a bit to cover those, but it's the drive that's going to pose the problem for the batsman. I think it's so much the two men in close, one on the leg side, a short leg, and the other one silly point. No way Williams is going to stop playing the drive. It's his main stroke. The thing to do is to capitalise on that. Single for it for a leg by it. Batsman wasn't kicking it away, he was merely trying to evade the ball.
Great delivery was that. Not expecting a bouncer first ball from Cork. Normally as a batsman you expect the bowler to loosen up first.
On the fumble, Illingworth might have had the batsman, the non-striker's end struggling if he'd gone for that. I think the batsman at Russell's end was okay, but the other one was only just starting off.
He's flicked that away with absolute contempt. Dominic Cork can't afford to stray down there. Uppish. But it's found the gap, and no shortage of shots here this morning. He's got rhythm. I don't know about line and length. He's certainly got rhythm. That's a beautifully played shot. And that takes Stuart Williams to 50. Stuart Williams' first 50 in Test match cricket. It's been a very positive innings too. Whereas Stuart Williams has been very fluent. Sherwin Campbell, who's batted so well through the series, just hasn't found his timing at all. Oh, well bowled! Well, beautifully bowled by Richard Illingworth. Campbell showing signs of that frustration, overbalanced, came down the pitch and Jack Russell just couldn't gather it. That's the perfect delivery. I'm afraid it's beaten batsman and wicketkeeper.
Well, had Jack Russell taking this cleanly, Campbell would have been run out, not stumped. A really bad miss here by Jack Russell, very uncharacteristic of him. Bad miss.
That appears to just drift away. That's the swinger drifting away. Is he almost an out swinger? And that did hit something, hit a bit of rough. Pop back at Jack Russell. And he did well to get behind and stop it. And that's another good shout. You see the batsman not attempting to play a shot with the bat.
I think the umpire must have thought that that might have even been pitched just outside, perhaps even leg stump. It went straight on, but might have been pitched outside leg. But again, very close.
That's a fine shot. Just dropped short then by Richard Illingworth, looking for a little variation in the air perhaps, and nice meaty sound in that bat.
Well, there's just no margin at all. So hard to make yourself pitch it up all the time. You get a few balls up there bringing the batsman forward, but very difficult to get them forward, six balls out of six.
In the air, caught, well bowled, beautifully bowled, and a good catch. Really was the art of slow bowling. Stuart Williams picked up some confidence from that shot of the back foot, was drawn down the pitch, and caught by Atherton at mid-off hop. Illingworth for 62, it's 77 for one.
Well, it was a nice innings, but if you remember, this was his first shot of the morning, and it actually went about similar height, a little wide of Michael Atherton at mid-off. This time it went straight to the skipper.
And there'll be a big applause for Brian Lara as he makes his way to the middle. ...77 for 1, and that's the sort of tempo of wicket-taking that England must expect until they get lower down the order.
That's a good stroke. It's again a bit too short.
Yes, he's such a clever player, Brian Lara. He threatens to come forward here, look, the front foot, but then he's so quick to rock back.
You've got a chance with him if you're pitching it into the footholds outside off stump. You don't have much chance if it's short. 8 from 2 balls.
And Sherwin Campbell's got to be careful here. He's got to bounce the first ball from Cork. Shot. That will race away. Campbell's first boundary this morning and brings up the 100. For West Indies, 101 for one.
Not much doubt about that. As it was halfway down the pitch, it had 4 written all over it. A wide half volley.
Yes, he was, but Indy played so well. I think he just seized the ball so quickly.
Very delicate, and 4.
Brian Lara immediately into the back foot. This pitch has not really got a lot of pace, and he recognizes immediately that he could play that on the back foot, even though it was not so short. Just guiding it through the back foot. Maybe where his third slip would have been for 4.
And repeating the dose. Just adapting the shot to the needs of the delivery. Allowed in at any age here at Trent Bridge. to stand and deliver. Already there's a case for Michael Atherton deciding that he's going to need an in-outfield, the sort that keeps the odd close catcher there, but also prevents the boundaries flowing as they are at the moment for Brian Lara. Not only has he that happy knack of keeping the strike, he has that happy knack of finding the gaps. Well, he's going to get four more for it. It bounced a foot in front of Gully.
Well, Angus Fraser continuing to bowl wide, just with one slip and one gully. Well, one slip and two gullies. One gully pretty fine and one very wide, inducing Lara to play into that area, but he's been so much in control. Be very difficult to get him out in this circumstances. I think you need to be bowling straighter.
Well, that's just guided away. It takes Brian Lara to 50 in what seems nothing more than the blink of an eyelid. Wherever Michael Atherton has put fielders, Brian Lara has completely ignored them, has found the gaps. That's his 10th boundary in 51 runs.
Well, Craig White is an all-rounder, very lively medium pace, and I think these conditions would be ideal for him.
A splash through gully. The close fielders are very close. Too close for something like that, which has been hard played. A catchable height, but travelling fast.
It's frustrating for the bowlers, but just need to come to terms with it. The timing is so wonderful. And that's why I reckon you need the two slips in and possibly the gully. That most times he hits that beautifully, but every so often there's a false stroke. Just gives you a little opportunity.
Well, that might have hurt Jack Russell. Illingworth is bowling to pitch at the rough outside the leg stump. So he goes straight for that rough outside the leg stump and does turn a long way. Appear to go over the stumps. Oh, we're having a change of bowling. Mike Watkinson is the man who's been brought into the attack. Oh, that's a very fine shot. And what a fast outfield it is. Not just playing the shot, but having the wonderful timing and the good sense to play it late and fine. One run. And that is the 100 partnership. First wicket fell at 77.
Richard Illingworth, who's bowled basically non-stop with only lunch in between, is now being replaced by Craig White.
What a glorious shot. Full stretch, full pace. And a big shout there.
Watkinson bowling around the wicket. I think this was very close from the umpire's point of view. For the batsman, correcting the fieldsman, would have thought he's playing no shots, he's padding out. Bat is just behind the pad.
More shouting.
Again, another shout. This one clearly outside off stump, and hardly likely that that would have hit the off stump since it would have been turning away from the left-hander.
That's flashed away. And it's not a contest. There's Craig White giving Brian Lara too much room just outside off stump there. And Brian Lara, the first on either side to 500 runs in the series. West Indies 203 for 1. And all Brian Lara's teammates assembling out on the balcony in anticipation of a wonderful 100. That's it. It's a wonderful 100 for Brian Lara. It has been a superb exhibition of high quality batting. Shouts, the ball gone out to silly points, and he's out. Nigel Clues eventually raising the finger. Sherwin Campbell's long vigil is over. Caught off bat and pad at silly point. And after 306 minutes, 225 balls, Sherwin Campbell out for 47.
Well, Watkinson doing here for his captain what he's required to do, an inside edge, summon to the pad, a very confident appeal. And then umpire Nigel Clues taking a relatively long time to put his finger up, but once that's up, you're gone.
Well, that must have been a very, very faint nick. And with Sherwin Campbell gone, West Indies captain Richard Richardson, the next man due at the crease. Well, if you're talking about gifts, there's one. Richard Richardson, it's easy on that. It's a poor delivery from Mike Watkinson.
That's what Lara has done. That's when he's at the Radcliffe Road end. And again, there's a preponderance of scoring strokes behind point, around to, well, just in front of point. Just for the sheer beauty of it, not necessarily for the four runs, we'll have another look at that most glorious square drive, just in front of point. Oh! Well, not quite on the same level as Nick Knight, but not far off.
Well, this looks pretty close. Maybe just got outside, but it's a very fine line. I don't think you'll convince the Dominic Cork or the wicketkeeper or many of the England players who are in a reasonable line to see this. No problem about the height.
Anchor straight up. Oh, dear me. He's given that something. A lovely stroke. Beautiful the way he plays that. He picks it up. It's not a thing where he smashes it into the ground, but just picks it up there. Fraser's muttering a few things that you wouldn't want passing across your breakfast table. There's every right to. One ball that's hit for six, and then the next one wide outside leg stump and just swung away down to fine leg. Nice crowd scenes there. There'll be plenty of people around delighted to be close to Kirtley Ambrose.
He's caught him. Well, that just looked like a little late cut. It all looked under control for Richardson. Just sliced away off the open face, straight into the hands of first slip.
Oh, this was totally unnecessary. This is catching practice. There's no, absolutely no future in that shot. It was not hit hard enough. It was not hit wide enough. Even if it had passed the slip, it probably would not have gone for four. Absolutely no future in this shot.
Well, a bonus for England. They stuck to it. I think Illingworth has bowled very well indeed today. Plenty of variation. Not afraid to flight the ball. Was, oh! What a risky run. Well, Arthur hit the ball so hard at Atherton at mid-off. Really was in the danger zone. Atherton picked it up well, threw well, had it hit.
Well, this would have been close. Probably would have been in. I don't think, again, worth the risk.
Oh, beautiful shot. Finds the gap. Michael Atherton's in there at a short extra cover, hoping for a chance to catch Lara, but that's all along the ground, perfectly placed. Well, the bail is off. The bail is off. It was Cork who picked up a bail and put it back on at Old Trafford. Brian Lara doing the same thing. Well, there seems to be a certain amount of jocularity out there, hilarity. I think the wind must have blown it off. Well, in the air, sketchy sort of stroke, but it'll bring Keith Arthurton four runs. Did slice through the gully area. Not under control. West Indies move on to 286 for three. Arthurton's five.
Hey! Shouts from Jack Russell and from the man at square leg, asking for the stumping.
First thing here is that Brian Lara is playing very, very wide. The toe is still very much grounded.
Oh. Well, this is the time to get him. He's 124 and he's just played three rather loose-looking strokes. The concentration's gone. Now, Atherton's going down there to give him the steely look. From around about 9 inches. Tell him to get his nose down and be there at the close of play. or to push a single and let Arthur and get down there.
Yeah, Keith Atherton, I think, using his head then, allowing himself a single so that he could take the pressure off of Brian Lara.
That's four more. Once again, too short. It's been the crime of the spinners all day here at Trent Bridge. Too short, too short, too short. That's a lovely stroke from Lara. Watkinson's back on at the Ratcliffe Road end. Beautiful stroke off his toes. Just wide of the man. It slipped for four more. Going ball short. Ball short to Lara. And he'll thrash your way between forward point and third man. No trouble at all.
Brian Lara seems to be playing in fours these days. In recent times, it's either one ball that's beat him and or seemed to have beat him in the next one, four runs. The West Indies now at 300 for three. Brian Lara 133 out of those 300.
Full stop, full toss and four. Lightning fast outfield. Lara's made the bulk of his runs with fours. And he's now being severe on Watkinson. Stroke, but you simply can't give Lara, anyone for that matter, the scope to play strokes off the back foot all the time.
Yay!
Oh, almost.
That came back a long way from outside off stump. That's always the risk that the left-handers dredge. One potentially might just bite from the rough areas provided by the bowler's footmarks. It's the line and length that you can't really play at. And yet the feeling when you've let it go and the ball's turned back just to hit the stumps is not a pleasant one.
Yes, and the thing is, if you'd have putted it away with his front pad, which most batsmen do, most left-handers, get the front pad over there, kick it away, he'd have probably been given not out, even though he didn't play a shot, because the umpire wouldn't have been sure how far it would have spun back.
Well, the new batsman is Rajendra Dhanraj, coming in as night watchman. West Indies four down. Atherton gone for 13. Total now on 319. Going to find the gap yet again and take Brian Lara past the 150 mark. For the third time today, acknowledging the applause of the crowd and his West Indies colleagues. Guard for the catch, Brian Lara's out. The ploy has worked. Just disappointment for Brian Lara and for this capacity crowd at Trent Bridge. England trying their own up-to-date version of leg theory. It was just the thin little help round to Jack Russell that was enough. England had set the trap, as it were, with a leg side field, but I don't think even Dominic Cork expected it to come quite in that fashion.
Well, there was an element of luck in it to get him out this way, but give some credit to England, because at least they set two men back for their hook or pull.
Chivnarine Chanderpaul, superseded by the night watchman only a few minutes ago, but now with the wicket of Brian Lara, obliged himself to come out to the crease. He's got this one away. Chanderpaul now is also off the mark. Pretty simple case of pulling a short ball for four.
And done with the least possible effort as well. Five more added to take that along to 334 for five. Brian Lara, 152. Magnificent performance. Williams, 62. Campbell, 47. Richardson, 40. Atherton, 13. And the not-out batsman, the night watchman, Dan Rash, who was originally coming in at number 11. He's unbeaten on three. And Chanderpaul, unbeaten on eight. Nine extras, 334 for five. The bowling figures for England. A wicket for Cork, one for Watkinson. And three for Illingworth, who bowled pretty well. Just remember that he's got a broken index finger on his right hand, not his bowling hand, and he did a good job. But for much of the time, I thought those spinners were far too short today. You can't bowl as short as that and expect to get past batsmen out. And the state of the game after 3 days, three very good days. 440 for England and West Indies, 334 for five. Lara, 152. West Indies 106 runs behind, but the star of the day, certainly the young left-hander, and he talked with Tony Lewis after the completion of the third day's play.
Brian, congratulations.
Thanks very much.
Did you enjoy it?
Yeah, it was a good day. I wish I was still there at the end, but, got a glove onto the ball down the leg side, and I suppose these things happen.
Yeah. How did the pitch play? I mean, it did turn, we saw that, but it was quite slow, was it?
Yeah, it's a bit slow, but I think, our guys batted pretty well, and I think well done to Stuart and Campbell, who stuck out there, wasn't timing the ball. But I thought it was a very good batting track, and England showed that, and it's nice to see our guys getting some runs, and hopefully we go in tomorrow and get some more.
Yeah, take a look at yourself getting a century. We've got that for you just to take a look at.
You know what I intended to do. Oh. I wanted to stay there for as long as possible. I had a whole day tomorrow to bat.
Well, Brian, thanks very much for coming to talk to us. I know you just rushed out of the shower. And I have to wish you the best of luck, but moderately, you understand that.
No problem.
A wonderful young cricketer, Brian Lara, and we've had the pleasure of watching him make 100 at Old Trafford, and now another one here today, and they were equally good. Touch of class about everything he does, and beautiful timing, wonderful footwork. Now then, Geoffrey Boycott has his ideas on what went on today, what might have gone on, and what is going to happen tomorrow.
Well, there is a song from Dr. Zhivago, Lara's theme, and you could have played that all day today. It was Lara's day, a brilliant exhibition, some scintillating stroke play, and he thrilled everybody, perhaps but the England bowlers. All the West Indians, or most of them, made runs. It's such an easy pitch. But he just put it into context. A class act, and you can't follow that. Brian Lara was brilliant. For England, they didn't do anything wrong. The pitch is so good it is difficult to tell them what they could have done better. I thought Michael Atherton had a reasonably good day. Perhaps a couple of points he could have told the two spinners to pitch it up a little bit more, even over pitch, and make the batsman drive more rather than play off the back foot. And secondly, He bowled both spinners, Watkinson and Illingworth, from the same ends. He could have switched them round, just maybe causing a problem or two for the West Indian batsmen. Tomorrow, well, what have England got to look forward to? I think they've got to be positive, try and bowl the West Indians out quickly, make quick runs, and then think of giving West Indies an awkward session or two on the last day. Pigs might fly. Well, you've got to think positive in Test match cricket if you want to win Test matches.
Yes, certainly some good cricket today, and a lot of good stuff to come tomorrow as well. And we'll be on air tomorrow. That's the time, 10:55 a.m, BBC One, for the fourth day of the fifth Cornhill Test at Trent Bridge. For the moment, from this great ground, it's good night.
I played as a start.
Did the rough outside your off stump, especially when Richard Illingworth was operating into it, cause you any grief?
Yeah, well, I mean, when you bowl into the rough, it's very difficult to play your shots. But I try to use my pad as much as possible and try to...